Okay, let's have problem 9. A circular hole is to be punched in a plate that has a shear strength of 276 megapascals. So refer to the figure 1.11c, which is again clipped here. The working compressive stress for the punch is 345 megapascals. Compute the maximum thickness of a plate in which a hole 63.5 mm in diameter can be punched. If the plate is 6.35 mm thick, determine the diameter of the smallest hole that can be punched. So this is the figure, and to illustrate it further in more detail, so this is the enlarged part of the this tube, and the force is P, and it is subjected to compressive force, and the resulting compressive force is a compressive stress is denoted by sigma sub c. Then this sigma sub c is transmitted, which will be resisted by the shear strength of the edge of this like circular coin. So sigma sub c, this is the shear stress which develops around the edge or the surface of this punched coin-like shape object. So P is sigma sub c times area, and the area is area of a circle because this compressive stress is uniform over the circular area, and this shear stress is uniform also around this surface, and this area of the surface is like the lateral area of a right circular cylinder, which is circumference times thickness, or pi dt. So that's pi dt. So therefore, sigma sub c, we just use these equations here, should be sigma sub c times area should be greater than equal to shear strength of the plate times the shear area, which is pi dt. So sigma c, which is equal to 345 megapascals, allowable compressive stress for compression, times pi over 4 diameter square, should be greater than equal to 276 times pi dt. So cancel out pi d. So we have 345 times d over 4, which is 63.5 over 4, should be greater than 276 times thickness. So the thickness of the plate should be less than equal to 19.84 mm. So this is the maximum thickness, 19.84. Greater than this or lower than this will also be possible. So this is the maximum thickness of the plate that can be punched. For the second part, we used the same equation, 345 times d over 4 equals tau 276 times t, and t is given 6.35, so we can solve for the diameter, the smallest hole, or the diameter of the smallest hole that can be punched. So in this case, d should be greater than 20.32 mm, or the minimum diameter of hole so that it can be punched is 20.32 mm. So that's it for this problem. Okay, let's have sample problem 10. Assume that the axial load P applied to the lap joint shown below is distributed equally among the three 20 millimeter diameter rivets. What is the maximum load P that can be applied if the allowable stresses are 40 megapascals for shear in its rivets, 90 megapascals for bearing between a plate and a rivet, and 120 megapascals for tension in the plates? So this is the figure. Then let's draw the free body diagram. Considering one only plate, and these are the this is the top view, so we have the shear force in each rivet. As mentioned earlier, we should assume that they are equal. So therefore, for tension, because this portion is a hole, then the net area in resisting this load P is in this portion here. This is where the maximum tensile stress course at that section. And here we have to see the end view. So this is the net area. So therefore, the dimension of this net area would be 25 mm by 130 minus d mm, assuming d is in mm. So if tension of plates controls, so let's look at this free body diagram. So P is equal to allowable tensile stress for tension, or allowable tensile stress for tension should be greater than equal to P over net area, and the net area is 25 times quantity 130 minus D, the shaded area here. So sigma T is, should be greater than equal to P over net area. Sigma sub T is equal to 120 megapascals, greater than equal to P over 25 times 130 minus 20, where 20 is the diameter of the rivet hole. Solving for P, P should be less than 300, less than equal to 330,000 newtons. Next, if shear in its rivet controls, shear in rivets controls. So let's solve for the shear force in each rivet by summing up forces horizontal. So P is equal to 3V, and the shearing stress allowable should be greater than equal to V over area of rivet, where V is equal to 1/3 of P. So substitute into the equation, allowable shear stress is 40. 40 megapascal should be greater than equal to P over 3 over area of rivet, which is pi over 4 diameter square, pi over 420 square. Solving for P, P should be less than equal to 37,700 newtons. And finally, if bearing of between a plate and a rivet controls, then the bearing force is also V, which is P over 3. So sigma P should be greater than equal to bearing stress allowable, should be greater than equal to the bearing load over diameter times thickness, the projected area of a rivet. And sigma P is equal to 90 megapascals, greater than equal to P over 3 divided by diameter 20 times thickness of the plate, which is 25 mm. So therefore, P should be less than equal to 135,000 newtons. Since the lowest value of P is equal to 37,700, so meaning shear stress in the rivets controls, and the answer is P should be the maximum value of P, safe value of P is 37,700 newtons. So that's it. That's the answer for this problem here. Okay, for problem 11, a key prevents relative rotation between the shaft and the pulley. If the torque T is 2,500 Newton meter, if the torque T 2,500 Newton meter is applied to the shaft, determine the smallest safe dimension B if the working shear stress for the key is 75 megapascals. So this is the situation here. The key is located there, and this is the detail of the key. Now, to solve for the shear force that the key is subjected to, let's draw the figure, this detail here. Let's enlarge it. This is the key, and the shear force that pushes the key, or the key must support, is V. And this shear force can be computed from the applied torque by summing up moment about the center of this shaft here, O, and from there we can solve for T. So summation moment at O equals zero, so clockwise moment positive, so V times R equals the torque. And this is the detail of the key. The shearing area of the key is, because this is B, and the length is 70 mm, so the shear area is 70 times B mm square. So summation of moment about O equals zero to express V in terms of the torque, or to compute the value of v. So v times r minus torque equals 0. So v is equal to 2500 over 3. Then we compute or convert torque 2500 newton meter to newton mm, so that the unit of shear force is newtons. So we can cancel meters by multiplying 1000 mm per meter. So the shear force is 250,000 over 3 newtons. Then from shear allowable shear stress, 75 should be greater than equal to shear force divided by shear area, which is 7 TB. So allowable shear stress should be greater equal to shear force over shear area. So 75 should be greater than equal to 250,000 over 3 divided by 7 TB. So we can solve for B in mm. So B should be greater than equal to 15.87 mm for this system to be safe. So B is greater than 15.27 mm. Then for problem 12, a joint is made by gluing two plywood gussets of thickness T to wood boards. The tensile working stresses are 8.28 megapascals for the plywood and 4.83 megapascals for the boards. The working shear stress for the glue is 345 kilopascals. Determine the dimensions B and T so that the joint is as strong as the boards. So let's draw the figure first, then let's draw the free body diagram for the boards alone, then for the two plywood gussets, and then for the shear in the between the gusset, plywood gussets and the boards. So this is the free body diagram for the board alone. So this is the resulting normal stress, sigma sub wood board, then area of wood board, which is equal to 45 mm by 145 mm. Then for the two gusset plywood gussets, so P should be equal to sigma PG, or normal stress in the plywood gussets, times area of plywood gussets, and there are two. So that's the FBD. Then for the shear strength in the glue, so this is the plywood. This is where we have shear resistance along the contact between the board and these two plywood gussets. So we have here shear stress in the glue, then area, shearing area in the glue portion. So there are two sides also. So for this FBD and FBD1 and FBD2, so P is equal to sigma WB, area of wood boards, equals 2 times sigma of PG, normal stress in the plywood gussets, times area of the plywood gussets. So sigma, or allowable normal stress for tension in wood boards, is equal to 4.83. Then the area is, as I said, 45 times 145. Then it is equal to 2 times 8.28 times the area, which is thickness of the plywood gusset, times perpendicular to the board 145. So we can cancel 145 and solve 40. T is equal to 13.125 mm. Likewise, if we equate sigma WB, area WB, the force in the wood board, to the shearing strength of the glue, then it is equal to sigma WB, area of wooden board, is equal to 2 times shear stress in the glue times shearing area of the glue portion. The shearing area of the glue portion is this one in the top view part, and there are two areas, so that's why you multiply it by 2. So this is 4.83 times 45 times 145 equals 2 times shear strength in the glue is 0.345 megapascals, to be consistent with the units. Then the area, shear area, is, as I said, B times 145, this area here. So cancel out 145 and we can solve for B equals 315 mm. So that's it for this problem here. Let's have problem 13. The halves of the coupling are held together by four 16 millimeter diameter bolts. The working stresses are 83 megapascals for shear in the bolts and 103 megapascals for bearing in the coupling. Find the largest torque T that can be safely transmitted by the coupling. Assume that the forces in the bolts have equal magnitudes. So this is the given figure. So let's draw the free body diagram of the front half of the coupling and system and the shaft system. So this is the front half, and this is the torque applied, which is clockwise in this figure. So the force in the bolts should be counterclockwise as shown, and they are equal. So summation moment about O equals zero, clockwise as positive. So we have torque minus 4 times V times R equals zero, because there are 4 forces of same moment arm R. So therefore, shear force is equal to torque divided by 4R, and R is in meter, so that if V is in newtons, the answer, the units for torque would be newton meter. So let's just put the equation that way. Let's solve for V. So to solve for the shear force or the bearing force, let's consider first or assume first that shear in the bolts controls. So if shear in bolts controls, then the value of the shear force would be equal to allowable shear stress, which is 83 megapascals times the area of one bolt, which is pi over 4, 16 mm square. So if bearing of bolts, if shear in bolts controls, then shear force is equal to, as I said, allowable shear stress 83 megapascals times pi over 4 times 16 squared. So we'll get 16,688 newtons. Now, if bearing between bolts and coupling controls, then the shear force is equal to allowable bearing stress, which is 103 megapascals times the bearing area, which is diameter times thickness. So 16 times the thickness is 12.7. So 103 times 16 times 12.7. The shear force is 20,930. Therefore, the safe value of the shear force is 16,688 newtons. This controls shearing in the bolts controls. And therefore, substitute into this equation here. So 16,688 equals torque over 4 times 0.089. The torque should be equal to 5,941 newton meter. So that's it for this problem. Okay, let's have problem 14. The figure shows a roof truss and the detail of the connection at joint B. Members BC and BE are angle sections with the thickness shown in the figure. The working stresses are 70 megapascals for shear in the rivets and 140 megapascals for bearing stress due to the rivets. How many 20 millimeter diameter rivets are required to fasten the following members to the gusset plate? So members BC and BE. So this is the figure, and this is the detail of joint B. So first, for member BC, obviously, if we isolate joint C, BC would be 96 kilonewtons tension. So then for the BE, we have to section this panel here. And this is now the free body diagram. And because this is 3 meters, 4 meters, so the hypotenuse is 5. So if we move force BE along its line of action, transfer it at E, there are two components, horizontal and vertical. So the horizontal component passes through A because we plan, or I plan, to solve for the force in BE by summing up moments about point A. So only the vertical component has moment about A, and it is equal to FBE times vertical component of distance 3 divided by distance 5. So that's it for BC. We have to concentrate for BC first. If shear in rivets controls for member BC, Then the 96,000 newtons load should be less than equal to the number of rivets times allowable shearing stress, which is 70 megapascals, times the area of one rivet. So 96,000 should be less than equal to the number of rivets, allowable shearing stress, then times area of one rivet, which is pi over 4 diameter square. So therefore, solving for n, n is greater than 4.365, say 5 rivets. If bearing stress controls between the plate and the rivet, so we have to compare the thickness of the angular bar, which is 6 mm, to the thickness of the gusset plate, which is 14 mm. Since 16 mm is less than 14 mm, this bar will be critical because it is thinner. So the thickness to be used is 6. So 96,000 should be less than equal to the number of rivets times allowable bearing stress, which is 140, times the contact area or projected area, which is diameter of the rivet times thickness. So 996,000 should be less than equal to n times allowable bearing stress. Diameter is 20, the thickness is 6 mm. That this should be the thickness that controls. So solving for n, n is greater than 5.714, say 6 rivets. Therefore, for member BC, there should be 6 rivets to be attached. Then for member BE, so let's consider this free body diagram. So we sum up moments about A. So clockwise positive. So PBE times 3 over 5 times 8 plus 96 times 4 equals 0. These are the only forces that must be considered. All the other two pass through point A. This member CE here and the line of action of PD pass through point A. So solving for PBE, it is equal to negative, means it is a compression member, negative 80 kilonewtons. So N times, if shear stress in rivets controls, so N times 70 times pi over 420 square should be greater than equal to 80,000. And solving for N, N is should be greater than 3.638, say 4. Then if bearing stress controls, so if bearing between the bar and the rivets controls, so we must compare the thickness of the of bar BE, which is 13 mm, to the gusset plate, which is 14 mm. Since 13 mm is less than 14 mm, this member will be critical in bearing. So 80,000 or N times allowable bearing stress 140 times diameter 20 times thickness 13 should be greater than equal to 80,000. So solving for N, N is greater than equal to 2.1883. Therefore, for member BE, we use 420 mm diameter rivets. So that's it for this problem. I hope that you were able to follow the solutions and the explanations.